In the last session, we discussed about some basic concepts of continental drift theory. Today, we are going to solve some MCQs from that chapter, which are frequently asked in the previous year questions paper of UGC NET. The questions are related to the last video. If you did not watch the video, please take a look on that for clearance of your concept about this theory. And if you need any kind of study material from this topic, you can contact me. My mail ID is given on the description box. Please watch the video till the end. And if you think this video is valuable for you, then please subscribe our channel and share the video to other students. Okay, so let's go to the first question. The first question is, Alfred Lothar Wegener was a option A meteorologist, geologist, meteorologist and geologist, meteorologist and geophysicist. We already discussed about this on the last video. We know the answer will be option D, the meteorologist and the geophysicist. The next question is, Wegener propounded the continental drift theory in the year 1912, 1920, 1922 or 1932. So, the answer will be option A, 1912. The next question is, in which year Wegener's continental drift theory was came in light? Option A, 1912, option B, 1920, option C, 1922 or the option D, 1932. So, we all know that the continental drift theory was came in light in 1922. So, the correct option is option C. The next question is, what is the main objectives of Wegener behind his displacement hypothesis? Option A, how two continents are displaced. Option B, examine the similarity of coastal margin. Option C, to explain global climatic change. Or the option D, to identify the rate of plate movement. We all know that the Wegener was a meteorologist, so his hypothesis was to explain the global climatic change. So the correct answer will be option C. The next question is, according to Wegener, Pangaea means option A, united of all land masses, option B, united of all water bodies, option C, fragmented water bodies, or the option D, whole earth crust. We know that Pangaea means united of all land masses. So the correct answer will be option A. Question number 6 is, according to Wegener, the westward movement of the land masses was caused by gravitational force, force of buoyancy, gravitational pull force, or the tidal force. We know that there was two kind of forces, the gravitational force and the tidal force. The westward movement of the land masses are basically caused by the tidal force. So the answer will be option D. Okay, question number 7 is, according to Wegener's continental drift theory, the Pangaea was broken into two parts and the Gondwana land was disrupted during the period of Cretaceous period, Miocene period, Eocene period or Paleocene period. So the answer will be Cretaceous period, option A. The next question is, Wegener believed that Pangaea was intact until option A, Permian period, option B, the late Carboniferous period, option C, Silurian period or the option D, Ordovician period. The answer of this question will be answer option B, the late Carboniferous period. Wegener believed that Pangaea was originated near the North Pole, Equator, South Pole or the Tropic of Cancer. According to Wegener, the Pangaea was originated near the South Pole, near the Antarctica. So the correct option will be option C. Question number 10 is, Wegener's continental drift theory was criticized on option A, focuses applied is not sufficient, option B, jigsaw fit cannot validate it, option C, did not describe the situation of pre-carboniferous times, and option D, all the correct. Yes, the Wegener's theory was criticized on all the topic from the given options. So the correct answer will be option D. The next question is, according to Wegener, the Pangaea was united about 100 million years ago, 200 million years ago, 150 million years ago, or 300 million years ago. The Pangaea was united about 300 million years ago. So the answer will be the option D. The next question is, Laurasia is consist of combination of Europe, Asia and North America, combination of Europe and Asia, combination of Africa and Europe, combination of Asia and Australia. The Laurasia means the north part of the equator. So the correct answer will be combination of Europe, Asia and North America. The correct option is option A. Question number 13. The Tethys is situated between Gondwana and Australia, Asia and Europe, Laurasia and Gondwana land, Asia and Eurasia. The correct answer of this question is option C, Laurasia and the Gondwana land. The next question is, according to Wegener, most of the new fault mountain were originated during the period Mesozoic era, Tertiary era, late Mesozoic era, or pre-Carboniferous era. The correct option will be option B, Tertiary era. All the new fault mountains were originated on the Tertiary era. The next and the last question of this session is, according to the continental drift theory, the movement of the continent towards equator due to gravitational differential force and the force of bouncing, ocean current, tidal force or Coriolis force. We all know that the equatorward movement of continents are due to gravitational force and the force of bouncing. So the correct answer will be option A. That's all for this session. Thank you for watching. Keep watching and keep learning. And don't forget to subscribe.